Our question this week is about pine trees. Jesse's tree is about 8 years old and it's lost a lot of foliage this year. Is there anything he can do? Pine trees generally don't do well in Austin's alkaline soils. Texas pines are adapted for acidic soil conditions. The Afghan pine is one of the best candidates for our soil, but it is not well acclimated to our rainfall and humidity, making it vulnerable to the fungal infection, Diplodia tip blight. If caught early, Diplodia can be managed through sanitation and fungicide. You can contact a certified arborist to help you determine if that is what's causing the foliage loss and what treatment might be appropriate. We also got a question from Julia and others about trees dropping their leaves in summer. In Julia's case, her healthy, established red oak lost half its leaves after recent 10-inch rains. Is this a problem? Many trees, especially red oak and sycamore, respond to summer drought and heat by dropping their leaves early. For many of these trees, the late summer and fall rains will help them restore vigor going into winter, but the stress that caused the early leaf drop initially needs to be considered in future cultural practices. So to mitigate the stress of summer drought, be sure to maintain 3 inches of mulch over as much of the root zone as possible. And for established trees, water deeply once a month if there hasn't been at least an inch of rain. And from Ron in Blanco about his pecan tree. The leaves turn brown in late August. This does not look good, especially because the trees around it appear to be doing okay with the summer heat and drought. I wouldn't rush to remove this tree. This may also be early leaf drop from the drought and heat, and perhaps the recent rain will help replenish it. If this were my tree, I would wait and see how the tree leaves out in the spring. If spring leaves are only sprouting along the branches and not out at the tips, then it is dying back, and it would be better to remove while it's safe to climb rather than waiting until it becomes hazardous and brittle. And in Texas, we celebrate Arbor Day in November, since fall is the best time to plant trees. So if you're looking for a small to medium-sized tree, consider our native mountain laurel. They are very drought tolerant, have beautiful purple flowers in early spring, are compatible for just about any size constraint, and do well under utility lines. They have hardly any insect or disease issues. The only thing that seems to cause them to turn yellow is too much water or poor drainage. We get a lot of questions about flowers on mountain laurels and how to make sure you get the maximum flower production. One thing to consider is where is the tree sited? If a mountain laurel is in deep shade, as with many trees, it's not gonna really do maximum flower production. So typically with most species, including mountain laurel, they need full sun to really achieve that maximum flower potential. Also, people often wanna know when is the best time to prune a mountain laurel tree so that you don't impact the flower production in the spring. So the best time to prune would be in the summer, after the tree has finished its flower show. So that way the tree still has time to set new growth, new flower buds that will emerge in the following spring. To learn more about trees and Austin's urban forestry program, visit austintexas.gov/trees. And we'd love to hear from you. Please visit centraltexasgardener.org to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.